Hi, I'm Gary White for Central Kentucky Television. I'm here with Marion County Chamber of Commerce Executive Director Stacy Mattingly. And there has been an announcement recently that you're not going to be able to have the Farm, Home, and Garden Show this year.
That is correct, Gary. You know, unfortunately, we had really hoped, had high hopes that we would get to continue out, you know, that event. But this year, we just don't have a venue. We have been meeting, you know, with the Ag Committee since December and just discussing several different options, you know, that we thought were good options in Lebanon. And none of them just didn't work out. You know, they were either too small or there wasn't ample electricity. You know, there's a lot of things that go into an event like that that some people may not realize what all goes into it. And, you know, having the ample space for people and these vendors to be able to physically drive in and unload was a really nice added, I guess, benefit to these vendors. And to take that away from them, I think would have, you know, have been detrimental on the show as well.
So the show was, I think last year we were discussing, it was approximately the 18th year for the show, and it had been held at the tobacco warehouse for many, many years.
Yes.
But last year you actually did have it at a new venue.
We did. We had it, you know, at the tobacco warehouse. It was when it was owned by I guess it was Philip Morris or whomever. You know, they were gracious enough to allow us to use that building, and the space was wonderful. I mean, you know, you could drive in, and there was a lot of electricity. And actually, they sold that building to American Wood Fibers, which is a local manufacturing here. And that first year that American Wood Fibers bought it, there was still space in there for us to have the show. Now, this past year, American Wood Fibers has grown so much that they are utilizing all that space, which is great. You know, we want our businesses to succeed in Marion County. So, I mean, that's a very positive note. So last year in 2014, Kenny Merritt was gracious enough to allow us to use one of his buildings that was back behind Lee's. And it went great there. I mean, it was a super clean, super nice venue. And unfortunately, though, for us, that building sold again. It's great for him and great for Marion County, but it did sell. And so once again, we were out of a location and trying to find something that would be feasible for everyone. You know, like you and I were talking about just recently, we had talked to the Fair Board, and the Fair Board was very welcoming for us to do something at Flora Hall. However, if you do something there, you know, we would have vendors that were inside, vendors that were outside, and that's not fair to some of the vendors to pick and choose. So we were stuck with that, and purchasing a tent, you know, to have up for vendors. Number one, that's not the ideal setting in April, but, you know, that is another added expense that would have been there as well.
So again, the Farm, Home, and Garden Show won't be able to be held in April this year.
Right.
Are there any ideas for what may take that place or future?
Well, you know, the Board of Directors did a strategic planning in January, and there have been some mention of some new events that we may try to do leading up into the summer. You know, the city's doing the bicentennial celebration this year, so I know we're focusing a lot on helping the city out with that. So if we don't get to something this year, you know, once again, we will revisit the Farm, Home, and Garden Show for 2016. And if it doesn't work out, then we will for sure try to find something for the community and for family members to attend. Yes.
Thank you very much. Again, I've been talking with Stacy Mattingly at the Marion County Chamber of Commerce.